here. I have been missing you so much, and I've been missing acrobatics a lot too. I guess you guys have, so we better do an acrobatics class. So, are you ready to warm up with me?
Thank you.
everybody's least favorite part, strength and conditioning, but we have to do it anyway, because otherwise we won't grow up to be strong. So our first exercise is our plank position. Do we all remember it? I'll show you anyway. So remember, our bottoms are not allowed to be up in the air, and they're not allowed to be down like this, because that's very bad for our backs, isn't it? So we have to be in a nice straight line the whole time. Primary level, you are going to do 5 seconds. Level one, you're going to do 10 seconds. And level two, you're going to try to do 20 seconds. Alrighty, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Well done, everybody. Next, we have our Superman pose, or as I like to call it, the Miss Lacey pose, because we fly with two arms out in front, don't we? Okay, here we go. 5 seconds, and then 10, and then 20. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Whew. Good job, everybody. Let's do our tabletop now. Now remember, we have to squeeze so that our tummies make a tabletop, a straight line. Maybe you could hold a cup of water on your tummy. Ready, steady, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good job. Next we have our wall sit. I think this is my favorite because it's so easy. So sitting up against the wall, our backs are flat against the wall, and we bend down. Make sure our legs make an L shape. Ready, steady, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. All done. Not all done. We have two more. First, we have our V sit. Now, for primary students, this might be a new one for you, but you are more than welcome to give it a go with everybody else. Maybe you can come back to acro class and show us this new trick. So, we have to lean back and our legs make a V. Do we all see? So again, we have 5 seconds, 10 seconds, or 20 seconds. Remember, if you start to get tired, you can bend your knees just a little bit. Okay, ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Whew, we're almost there. So the next exercise we have is handstand facing the wall in pike, which is the one where we make an L shape with our bodies. Now for primary students, I want you all to put your hands on the ground and just lift one leg
up to the sky. Can you hold this for 5 seconds? Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come on down. Now can you try on the other leg as well? Ready? Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well done. Now for level one and level two students, you are going to come to the wall, put your hands down, and then you slowly put your feet onto the wall and kick up to an L position. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Come on down. That is the end of our strength and conditioning, everybody. You did a great job. Okay guys, great job with your strength and conditioning. Now it's time to move on to our balance. The very first thing we have is our left foot retire balance. Now retire means that we bring our foot up to our knee, and this leg, our supporting leg, has to be nice and straight, remember? And our pointed foot has to be just that. It has to be pointed. Okay, so my primary kids, you have 5 seconds, level one, 10 seconds, and level two, 20 seconds. Let's see if we can do it. If you have to come down, just come down and then restart. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Come on down, very well done. Now, of course, we have our right foot balance. So we have to do it all again. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Come on down. Next we have our rise on point, which is both feet just onto the balls of our feet, like this. Awesome. So primary, you have to hold it for 5 seconds. Level one, also 5 seconds. And level two, 10 seconds. Ready? Let's do it together. And rise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Come on down. See guys, even Miss Lacey struggles with that one. That was pretty tricky. Well done. Next we have our baby scorpion. So we cook our right leg up and hold it with our right hand, and our left hand is out in front, and our knees stay together. Ready? 5, 5, and then 10. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Come on down. And you guessed it, we have to do it on the other leg. Ready? And go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job, everyone. We're nearly done. Come on and take a seat. Okay, so our legs come out in front of us and our knees are going to spread apart. We have our seated double leg hold. Now I think this is only in the level 2 level, but primary and level 1, if you would like to give this a go, it's a great balance skill, okay? So this is called seated double leg hold, and we have to hold onto our heels with our hands and lift them up into a V shape. Now the first thing I want you to focus on is that your knees are nice and straight, okay? Once you've got that one and aren't wobbling around like crazy, I want you to focus on straightening up your back. So, do you see how my back is really curved at the moment? You have to straighten up and poke your chest out towards the wall that you're facing. And then try and hold that. It's a pretty tricky one, but I think you guys can do it. So again, primary and level 1, just try for 5 seconds, okay? Level 2s, I want you to try and aim for 10. I believe in you. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Come on down. So close, we only have one more skill. This next one is, I know, some of your favorites. This is called teddy bear stand. So we start kneeling and we put our hands flat on the floor in a straight line. Good. Now we make a triangle and the point of our triangle is our head on the ground. So we put our head down to make the point of the triangle and our toes are sticking on the ground like this. We slowly raise our knees off the floor and walk our toes towards our hands. When we are ready, we put our knees on our elbows really slow and really slowly lift one leg off and then our second leg off and see how long you can balance. I'm going to count. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Very well done, everyone. That was a pretty tricky skill as well. How did you go? Hopefully when we get back to class, you can show me how much you've improved. Next, we have our limbering skills. So remember, there are 3 different levels, primary, level 1, and level 2. Primary students, I want you to do your primary skills. And if you feel confident, you could maybe try the level 1 skills as well. Just make sure you're doing them safely, okay? Level 1 students, I want you to do the primary and level 1 skills, and if you feel confident, you can give the level 2 skills a go as well. Level 2, I want you to do the primary, level 1, and level 2 skills, because it's always good to go back to the beginning and relearn the basics. Okay, here we go, starting with our primary skills. This is called baby bridge. So, we are laying down with our backs against the floor and our knees up to the roof. Our hands are flat on the floor as well. And all we are going to do is lift to make our bodies a straight line all the way from our shoulders to our knees. Let's hold this for 10 seconds, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Come on down. Oh, good job. So next we have our tendu devant to starting position. Who knows what this is actually going to start? I think it would be our cartwheels and our handstands especially. So standing up nice and tall, we point our favorite leg to the front in front of us and make sure our toes are pointed. That's very important. If you have ever had a class with Miss Lacey, I love pointed toes. And we bring our hands out in front of us and then nice and straight, just like this. And we're looking straight ahead so that we are all ready to go into our cartwheel. Well done. Our next position is our tendu de second ending position, which is going to be ending our cartwheels. Isn't it lucky that we've just practiced the beginning and now we're going to practice the end?
So we are pointing our foot out to the side. Our same arm as leg is up to the sky, and our other arm is out to the side, making an L shape with our hands. And we are looking straight ahead. Well done, everyone. Now we're going to move on to our level one skills. So we're going to begin with our push up to bridge. Again, we start laying down. Our feet flat on the floor, knees up to the roof. We're going to bring our hands to our shoulders, our fingertips facing our feet. Then, with one big push, we are going to shoot our arms straight up and our knees up to the sky. And we're going to hold this just for 5 seconds. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come on, dear. Remember to tuck our chins into our chests when we're coming down. Well done. Next, we have our tendu to second ending with a transfer of weight, which is exactly the same as primary. Sorry about that. So it's exactly the same as the primary skill, but we start and then we do a big bend and we come back to the other side. And you can go back the other way as well. Bend and stretch, making sure that the arms come to an L shape every time. Let's do it twice more. Bend and stretch. Bend and stretch. Well done. Now we can move on to our level two skills. We are going to start with our bridge waving. So remember, only taking one hand off at a time. I'll face the camera so that I can wave at you all. So again, we start laying down with our feet flat against the floor, hands by our shoulders, and we push up to bridge. And now I'm going to wave at you. Can you wave back at me? And now swap hands. Well done. Come on down, tuck your chin and lower. Good job, everybody. Now, instead of lifting our hands off the floor this time, we're going to lift one foot. This is called bridge retire. So we bring our feet up to our knee, just like this. If you're really advanced, you could lift it up to a decollete, straight up to the roof, but then bring it back down to the floor. Make sure you do the other leg as well. Retire, decollete, retire, and back down. How did we go with that one, guys? That's pretty tricky. All right, we have one more skill, and this is a new one. It's brand new this year. It's called kneeling half bridge. Okay, so we start kneeling up on our knees, hands out to the front. We bring our hands up and we breathe in, and then we lower ourselves this way towards our back, and our hands stay straight. We go. And then back up, just like that. You don't have to hold it for long. It is just straight down and straight back up. I'll do it one more time. How did you go with that one? That is a brand new skill. So last but definitely not least, we have our tumbling. First, we're going to start off with our rock and rolls. Do you guys remember these? So we're going to start off with our primary rock and roll, which is sitting to sitting, and we stay in our tuck position the whole time. Remember, level one and level two, so you can do this as well to warm up. So we start in our tuck position, our head tucked into our knees nice and tight, and all we do is rock and come back to our tuck position. Maybe do this four more times. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. Well done.
So the next rock and roll that we are going to do is the level one rock and roll. Primary students, if you felt comfortable with your rock and roll, you can try this one as well. So this one, we start standing and then we come back to our standing position, but our legs still stay in tuck. So hands by our sides, we squat down to the floor, rock and roll, and then we stand straight back up. Now, try really hard not to cross over our feet before we stand up to help us. I know it makes it easier, but it'll look a lot nicer if we keep our feet nice and straight together. Okay, let's do this four times together. One. Two. Now we have our level two rock and roll, which is rock and roll, standing to standing, candlestick. So I'll demonstrate this for you. Primary level ones, if you feel confident, you can do this one too, but please make sure you tuck your chin into your chest. Now, we start and finish exactly the same way. We rock down, but this time our hands come flat onto the mat, and our legs kick up to the sky. And then we stand straight up. It's a little bit tricky, and I want you to think about raising your feet all the way to the ceiling, really lengthening through your whole body, okay? We have four of these. One. Two. Make sure your hands are flat on the floor. Three. Four. And that's all the rock and rolls we have. Shall we get on to some somersaults and some forward rolls? I think so too. So our primary levels, we start down in a squat. And remember, the most important thing for our somersaults and forward rolls is to tuck our chin into our chest so that we don't hurt our backs, okay? Our hands are flat on the floor, and we tuck and we roll over into our tuck position to finish. Shall we try that two more times? Come to the side, whoops, Miss Lacey's balance is off. Naughty Miss Lacey, okay. Our hands are flat, we tuck our chin, and we roll into our tuck. One more time. Good. Tucking our chins, and roll. Well done, everybody. Now, level ones, we have our forward pike roll. Okay, remember this is the one where we finish in our pike position, folded over our legs, okay? So, we start from standing. Remember, it's just as important now to tuck our chins. We bend, tuck, and pike finish. How did you go? Do you know if you landed on your top of your head or on the back of your shoulders? Remember that it's very important to land on the back of our shoulders so that we don't crunch our neck, okay? Try this time to focus on what part of your head you're landing on. So we're standing. And head down, tuck into pike. Well done, everybody. Next, for our level twos, you have your forward roll, standing to standing. Again, it's very important that you don't cross your feet to stand up, okay? Feet together and you stand straight, nice and tall, okay? If you would like, you could do, and if you have the room, you could do two or three in a row. Standing, you roll, and stand up. Or you could just turn around and do it the other way, like me. And stand
Do it two more times. Tucking our head. Last one. Good job, everybody. How about we move on to cartwheels? These ones are my favorite. So, primary levels, you have your pre-cartwheel on your favorite side. Now, I know that some of you might not have a big block to cartwheel over. That's okay, you can just pretend. What I need you to focus on is that your two hands come down to the floor, and then your legs land. One, two. Yes? So, it should be four counts. One hand, two hand, three, four to stand up. Okay, and remember, we should finish in our second tondu with our arms in an L shape every single time we do a cartwheel. Every single time. Okay, so let's have a go. We have one hand, two foot. Yes. Now, let's do it one more time. And I want to see if you can speed it up and see if you can keep your knees nice and straight in the air, okay? Hand, hand, foot, foot, and finish. Very well done, everybody. Next, with the level ones, we have to do exactly the same thing, but we have to do it on both sides. Okay, so we've just practiced our favorite side. Now we have to practice the other side as well. So we point our other foot, hands out just like always, and we do hand, hand, foot, foot, and finish. Let's do it back this way, and then back this way, each one more time. Hand, hand, foot, foot. And back the other way one last time. Hand, hand, foot, foot. Finish. Well done, everybody. I hope that wasn't too tricky. Now with the level two cartwheels, it is just a normal cartwheel, both sides again. So keep practicing. We'll do two on each side again. Ready? Starting with our toe pointed and our hands out in front, we have cartwheel, finish, and stretch. Good. Back the other way. Cartwheel, finish, and stretch. Two more. Last one. Very well done, everybody. Last but not least, we have our handstands. Primary level, I want you to put your hands down like we did before. And the only difference is now, I want you to kick off the floor just a little bit with that big leg. Just a tiny bit. Okay? Just a tiny bit. And then I want you to come around and do it on the other side as well. Two hands on the floor and just a tiny jump. Even if you can only go to a rise on the toe, that's okay too. We all have different levels. Level one, I want you to do your your L handstand, which means you make an L with your legs. One leg comes to the roof and one leg kicks to the side. Okay? All the way. Foot to the roof, foot to the side. And we come back. Let's do three more. Kick and back. Kick and back. Last one. Kick and back. Very well done. Now, level twos, we have our pre-handstand, which is where our back leg kicks up and then comes right back down, and they have to clap together, your feet in the air. I'll show you now. And they clap, and then the same leg comes back down to the ground. So the one that you kick off comes down first. And you can do this with both legs. So you could use your bad leg as well. because we all know you have to work this one just as much as you work your favourite one. And kick. And down. One more on this bad side too. And down. Well done, everybody. That is the end of our class today. Thank you so much for coming to our ACRA class and having fun with me. Hopefully I'll see you soon. Bye.